face-to-face mode has its own benefits. It gives an opportunity for the students as well as teachers for having the face-to-face interactions with the teachers as well as with the fellow students. But at times, the time slot available in the face-to-face interaction is not sufficient, and then the teacher thinks of taking the class beyond the four walls. And then there comes the online teaching. Online teaching gives the benefits of having extended time, having different kinds of resources, interactions, and so on for the students as well as for the teachers. But at the same time, it has limitations in terms of the students facing isolation and not able to really take a judgment of how much time one should spend on online. If the student has doubts, then again there are problems with the students in online learning. In order to take the benefits of both the worlds, that is of face-to-face mode as well as online teaching, there is a blend of both the modes in terms of blended learning approach. In case of blended learning approach, there is a partial part dealt through face-to-face mode and a part of teaching is dealt through online mode. The blended learning combines the benefits of the traditional face-to-face classroom with those of the online teaching. The teacher needs to design the teaching learning process when she decides to take up the blended learning. Exactly what kind of part of the syllabus would go by face-to-face mode, which part will be going by online mode, and exactly how the assignments and her homework would be distributed, how the resources will be shared with the students, what exact group work would be expected of them, everything needs to be designed in a very, very careful manner. The responsibility of the teacher here is to create the environment in such a way that there is maximal student engagement. Because the very purpose of having the blended learning is to get the maximization of the student interaction and their engagement with their learning. And hence, the success of a blended learning depends on how the two modes are blended with one another and in what proportion they are blended. Before we move on further, we shall see certain definitions of blended learning. To combine any form of instructional technology, that is videotape or CD-ROM or web-based training or film, with face-to-face instructor-led training. This definition is given by Driscoll in 2002. Another definition says blended learning is a mix of delivery methods. In this definition, one can see the vastness of blended learning. The definition underlines the needs of various subjects as well as the needs of various kinds of audiences. Blended learning is the environment in which student learns at least in a part through online delivery of content and instruction, with some element of student's control over time, place, and path. We have seen three different definitions of blended learning. There are many such definitions available, and one can see through these definitions that a different attribute of blended learning has been appealed by the person who has defined the term. In order to have one simple consensus on what is exactly will be a part of blended learning, here is the definition that has been coined. We will see that definition. Blended learning is a formal education program in which the students learn at least a part through online learning with some element of student control over time, place, path, and or pace. The second feature is at least in part in a supervised brick and mortar location away from home. And the third feature is and the modalities along each student's learning path within a course or subject are connected to provide an integrated learning experience. So from this definition, one can note that there is definitely one feature that it's a mixture of both face-to-face mode and some online component is there. Depending on the learner's path and the teacher's decision to give the freedom about choosing the path and the pace and even the mode, there are possibilities of having the blended mode in various formats. While we are understanding the concept of what blended mode is, it is also important to understand what blended mode is not. Blended mode is not merely a combination of face-to-face mode where some peripheral online mode or a peripheral digital media has been used and the media are just merely layered. But it is very, very essential in case of blended learning that they are very logically and psychologically as well designed with purpose, the sequence and the amount, the quantum of both the modes. So it is not just, it is haphazardly mixed modes, or it is not just on the spur of the moment the teacher thought that okay, at this moment the online mode should come in, but it is definitely in a very, very planned order, and students are, or rather even their parents are also well informed about how the two modes will be blended with one another, at what point, what portion of the syllabus would come in through which mode. Why does one need to go for blended learning? Blended learning, since it has the possibilities of both the face-to-face mode as well as online mode, it is a pedagogically little stronger approach, because depending on the need of the students and the subject, or rather content that is to be dealt, one can decide on which mode to be followed at which point. And that is why the teacher has more options available at hand, and thus it becomes the more powerful pedagogical approach as compared to individually face-to-face mode or online mode. Since it has the benefit of having more access to knowledge in terms of having more access to the resources that are beyond the four walls of the classroom, blended learning has its own benefits. There are students in the classroom with varying learning styles. Each student has one's own different demands of the ways of learning. The blended learning gives the opportunity to have this tailor-made kind of module for every student that is in the classroom, and thus it deals better with the various learning styles in the class. While it offers the benefits of face-to-face mode in the classroom, it adds the flexibility to the classroom teaching, because it gives an opportunity to take the students beyond the classroom without actually leaving the four walls. Maybe at times it has its own benefits for the students. Blended learning has an advantage of having the use of effective teachers to a wider variety or wider population of students, which is not possible in only face-to-face mode. So in face-to-face mode, suppose one teacher is able to teach a class of say 50 or 60 students only. In case of adding the onlineness to the face-to-face mode, that is in blended learning, this teacher can then deal with the more number of students in the same organization or same school. Blended learning gives better opportunity for the student engagement and student learning. It, depending on the situation or depending on the content, the teacher adds more and more modes to the learning situation, and thus it gives the opportunity for the students to learn in a different variety of ways, as well as be engaged with the actually learning process as well as learning material. Here engagement is also with the other students. One learns not only with the learning material that is given, but along with the other students and also with the teacher. This also has an opportunity for more cooperative learning. So they have the face-to-face mode, they can have the maybe small group discussion kind of a modality can be used, whereas even if they are shifted to online mode, they can get benefited through the discussion forum. So the group discussion which they are having in the face-to-face mode in the classroom can go beyond the classroom, and that discussion can be continued even beyond the classroom through online mode. It also overcomes the disadvantage of having the isolation on the part of the student. Here the student has the benefit of face-to-face mode interaction with the fellow learners while one is learning through online mode. So here there is definitely a human-human interaction is possible and is taken the advantage of apart from the human and computer learning in case of online mode. What happens in a face-to-face mode is many a times the teacher tends to take over the class in completely teacher-centered way. She keeps on talking and maybe at times it happens that the students hardly have any scope for discussion. But in case of blended learning, since there are definitely certain slots at least designed in such a manner that the students are left on their own, here is an opportunity where the teacher-centered classroom doesn't hamper the learning of the students. It gives the maximum benefit of having student-teacher interaction along with the benefit of having the learner autonomy. Where especially when during those slots where the learner is left on his or her own for learning, that is the time where the learner autonomy comes into picture. There are certain models where the student will be choosing what one wants to go for or what one doesn't want to go for. So all this is the best blend of having the best of both worlds as we have been underlining it. Blended learning has the possibility of having variety of learning resources in terms of CDs or videos or maybe some good audios and so on. At the same time, it has the possibility of having a variety of teaching learning experiences. Maybe the teacher can ask sometimes to read on one's own, reflect on it. At times it could be a small group discussion through face-to-face mode, could be through online mode, could be at times that watching a video and having a discussion on it and so on. So thus it gives more flexibility for the teacher in terms of having the curricular transactions with the students, designing the curricular activities for the students, designing the learning activities for the students. And due to all these benefits of the blended learning, it is very, very advantageous that the teacher goes for the blended learning approach. The research also has reported that the blended learning approach gives better results in terms of student learning as compared to only face-to-face mode by the teacher. So thus, it takes the students beyond the classroom, beyond only those resources which the teacher can offer, and gives more benefits to the learners. And that is why the blended learning approach is much preferred approach at various institutions. What are the objectives of blended learning? We will see the objectives now. To provide effective and efficient learning experience to the students by combining multiple modes of instruction. In this objective, you would see the words like effective as well as efficient. So efficiency talks in terms of the time. So the learning time gets reduced, and the effective refers to the quality of teaching. So as we have seen in the earlier section, that the teacher is able to make use of the variety of resources and variety of learning experiences. Both this availability will contribute to the efficiency as well as effectiveness of the learning. The second objective is to provide opportunities for learner engagement, motivation, and collaboration. In blended learning, there are opportunities for student engagement and collaboration, not only during the classroom time, but even beyond the classroom time. And thus it gives the more opportunities for having such kind of interactions and having opportunities for students learning from one another apart from their learning from the teacher. What are the various tools that are available while learning through blended mode? Of course, print media would be the basic media that would be available. But apart from that, various digital media are available for the students. For example, let us see Wiki. So in Wiki, there are many people have contributed to the Wikipedia, which is available on online. And the students are able to not only learn from that, but if they are able to contribute something, even that opportunity is available for them. Students write blogs, and these blogs could be used by the students as well as by the teachers for their learning through blended mode. Online discussion forums is another option that is available. In the face-to-face mode, they have the possibility of having the face-to-face discussions, having the arguments, counter-arguments, bringing out various angles of the topic under discussion. And the online discussion forum helps to continue this discussion even beyond those, say, 30 minutes or beyond 1 hour during the rest of the day. And thus, it provides the opportunity of having the collaboration or cooperative learning through online mode. Then there are options like digital storytelling, flip classroom. Then there are web quests as well. Simulations are also made use of while using the online-ness in the blended learning. And there are also sometimes some mind mapping tools could be also used. So these are some of the tools that could be used by the teacher while using the blended mode. Now it is up to the teacher which tool to be picked up for which kind of a content, and that is where the need of the teacher is. This is the beauty of the blended mode, that while it takes the benefit of having the learner giving his or her own autonomy of choosing at times even the resources or the modes, the point where the person may get stuck up, there is an opportunity of having the teacher in the face-to-face mode as well. So one talks in constructivism about the zone of proximal development. So this that zone where the learner has come to its maximum capacity as per the present capacities, but there is a possibility of stretching this capacity further with the teacher's intervention. And this ZPD, that is a zone of proximal development, is perfectly caught in case of the blended learning. So the teacher can leave the students on their own, maybe through face-to-face mode or even through online mode especially. And when the teacher feels that here there will be a need for my intervention, or this is the point where I need to see what the students have done and give the comments on, that is the point where she can design having the face-to-face mode slot in the whole syllabus. Which are the various key components of in the blended mode? The first, of course, is the face-to-face mode, or the face-to-face interaction is the main component or the basic, which is very much familiar to many of the teachers. But apart from that, there are possibilities of self-paced training. So depending on the learner's choice of choosing the modes, and the further progress of the learner would be decided on that. There are possibilities of having the social learning, not only through face-to-face mode, but also through online mode. Nowadays, we see lot many social media, and this social media are also used, or they can also be used in the teaching learning process. In fact, they add a component of an informal setting for the teaching learning process. There are possibilities of mobile being used even in teaching learning process. It may be in the form of SMS, or maybe in the form of small videos, or maybe interactions through, say, WhatsApp, and so on. So all these various modalities are used, or they can be used in case of blended learning approach. There are possibilities of having the virtual classroom training in blended learning. So the teacher can have the face-to-face mode classroom, as well as she can organize a virtual classroom for the students where they are located at different geographical locations and they are interacting with each other and thus get benefited through each other's learning. Thus, there are different possibilities of having the variety of in case of blended learning. There are these categories are discussed. So they talk of the three main categories of blends. The first one is the enabling blend. Second one is the enhancing blend. The third one is the transforming blends. The first one, that is the enabling blend. In this case, the teacher has to take into consideration the learner attributes to a greater extent. The teacher has to confirm that the kind of online mode or the digital mode that she is planning for her students, the students are well versed with the technical know-how of that mode. And only if the students are ready for using that kind of a mode, then she can use that mode for the blended approach. So this was the enabling mode. Another category is the enhancing blend. Now, as the name suggests, enhancing, so there is something which is being used by the students. It has to be used for the higher level or for the learning purpose. We take an example of, say, social media. Now, we know that many of the students, they are connected with each other or with the society around through the media like WhatsApp or Facebook, Twitter. So, in this case, they are already using the media. They need not be taught per se how to use this media. So, technical know-how is already there. But where is the point of enhancement? The point of enhancement comes where the media which they are otherwise using for, say, chit-chatting or for sharing family photographs and so on, has to be used now for teaching learning process. So the content of their discussion through WhatsApp or through Facebook would now change to something which is a part of their syllabus. So here is the enhancement. It is the further, some further attributes are added to the media which they have been already using. Third and the last category of blend is the transformation, where the media is being already used and that is being transformed into something else. So suppose the students are using a print media, they are using a small group discussion in the face-to-face mode, which is being transformed that, okay, you will continue with the discussion or you will have some similar kind of a discussion, not through face-to-face mode, but you will shift to online mode now. So here is the transformation process of the media. So thus there are three different categories of the blends. Depending on the situation of the learning, the content, the student attributes, the teacher then decides about which mode to be used, where to be used, and in what proportion to be used. And it is a complete freedom of the teacher as well as a complete responsibility of the teacher as well.